Ueda in the blue.
Well, this is the fight that I and ONE FC fans around the world have been looking forward to over the last several months. Finally get to see who's going to be the most dominant in this Grand Prix. Both men know what's on the line.
I think both men were exceptional in the semifinals. Really anticipating a good final here.
Of course. I mean, regardless of who wins, either man is going to have a long career here in ONE FC. Both have been just completely dominant in their victories, too. Ueda with a submission choke and then a decision win, and then two TKO victories for Belingon.
Early on, Belingon looks a little bit hurried in his kicks, perhaps a little bit concerned about what might come back at him. Let's see how that develops.
Well, Kevin, I think, knows that Ueda is going to want to eventually take this to the ground. Ueda may throw a couple of punches to make Kevin respect his striking, but he's going to try to kick.
Whoa.
Sounded like he just cracked timber there. Nice takedown, nice stuff too. Kevin throwing a knee right back at Ueda. That'll make you slow down your takedown attempts if every time you miss, you get a hit from the face with a knee.
Oh wow, he went for the takedown and got a foot in the face. I don't think he'll do that again in a hurry.
Well, this would be a huge win for Kevin and really speak volumes to the Filipino mixed martial arts scene. A guy like Ueda who's beaten Hoyler Gracie, Rumina Sato, Jens Pulver. This would be a monstrous win, the biggest one of Kevin's career if he can come away with a W tonight. He's going to be methodical and a little more paced than I think we've seen him before.
He was always talent, wasn't he, when he entered the ONE FC cage the first time. Had a stuttery start, but he's really progressed in that time.
He's a tremendous striker, too. And Ueda has very good hands, but obviously his wrestling is really where that pedigree comes into play.
Swinging right and left, both missed from Belingon.
And again, yeah. A double-edged shot. Can Kevin stuff this? Ueda's in pretty deep, turn in the corner.
Elbow to the back of the head. And I wonder if he's just going to wrap that arm around the throat. Doesn't look like it. Goes for the elbow to the top of the head instead.
Well, this is a bad position for Kevin to be in, although he's working. Ueda's doing that thing that a lot of Japanese fighters like to do. They figure for the legs to try to stop you from scrambling. Kawajiri made it very popular, beating the tar out of all of his opponents over in Asia. Now Ueda's in the open guard to Belingon. Kevin should close his guard here, otherwise you're gonna see Ueda start to work the pass like he's doing. Only time that Kevin Belingon's been submitted was by Eminari, and the whole time that Eminari was going for leg locks, Kevin was still throwing heavy leather down on him. But he has to be careful because Ueda's a very well versed submission specialist.
Well, I fancy that Belingon learned a big lesson that day against Eminari. Will it pay dividends in this fight? Knees to the head, replied with knees to the body.
You know, Kevin really doesn't need to be holding down Ueda's head there. That shows a lack of experience. He needs to get that left arm underneath and protect it, and he needs to get that right elbow in close to his body, not around the hips of Ueda. He's actually letting Ueda control his back, keeping him flat there. This is a bad position. And a lot of guys you see on the bottom that hold guys down like that, they're thinking, hey, if I hold this guy down, he's not gonna posture up and throw punches, but you're exposing your limbs. You're exposing submission attempts and things like that. You're gonna see Ueda, who's a master of mat work here, start to set those submissions up. Start prying on that forearm like now. He's looking for a Kimura. Oh, he's locked it up. This is gonna be difficult. He's gonna try to step over here and look for that arm lock. Kevin's gotta be careful here. Nice job breaking the grip with his knee.
It was fantastic that the crowd knew exactly what was going on there. The roars went up, or the concern, I should say, was clearly audible. Belingon is free and on his feet. Ueda, a long way from home. Fair to say, with not too many friends in this arena. That's the end of the first round, and what a good round it was. Second round then.
How do you see this fight so far, Steve?
Well, I think I'd say Belingon slightly ahead. Ueda clearly has to take it downstairs, doesn't he, to the canvas there. That's where he will get the chance to own this contest. But Belingon is hyped up. I think he's learned so much. He's progressed so well in the last couple of years.
This really
is his stage.
I agree. I think he's really grown.
It's vicious, isn't it? The exchanges.
Kevin throws not nice. That's all I want to say. Not nice. They're throwing punches nice, and they're just throwing punches not nice. Kevin's on top here. Ueda misses the takedown. Let's see what Kevin can do here. He's got head and arm, and Ueda with a beautiful reversal. Poetry in motion
so
on the ground.
Smooth.
Ueda's back in cross mount here, and it's going to have some time to work. 3 minutes, 30 seconds left. Grand Prix title on the line. I'd love for this fight to go five rounds.
Wouldn't that be great?
It would be. I wish every fight was five rounds, as long as they're not fights I'm in, because my goodness, that takes a lot of cardio. But you know, sometimes you gotta see who's got that extra tenacity to finish these fights. Ueda has been a fantastic collegiate wrestler, has shown his ability to take guys down. Jens Pulver, who he submitted in the last round, was a college wrestler, very, very good at wrestling. Took him down at will, submitted him. So far, he's been able to take Kevin down, but not do too much with the takedowns.
With a little under 8 minutes left in this contest, you wonder, though, if it'll even go three rounds.
Well, Ueda's back on that Uma Plata. Now, this could be a straight armbar attempt, but these are very difficult to get from that angle.
He's giving it a good go, though, isn't he?
He is giving it a good go.
Look
however,
at the flex in that arm.
You see that Kevin's giving the thumbs up sign. Uh-huh. Those submissions are very difficult to get. You'll get them on guys that are beginners because, you know, as you get more advanced, you feel there's a pain tolerance you can take. There's a certain level of, you almost have this built-in radar of danger when you're fighting, and you go, okay, you know what? I'm okay here. It's going to hurt, but I'm just going to wear it out a little bit. Kevin Belingon did just that. He said, you know what? This is going to be close, but you're not going to catch me here.
Fever pitch at cage side. 20,000 MMA fans.
Oh, Kevin's on top, throwing some good punches to Ueda. Kicked
to
the head.
The action is absolutely furious. And
takedown? Not
just
today.
Just missed with the foot, with the kick to the head there.
Both guys know what's on the line here. This could easily line one of these two guys up for a title shot. Both men undefeated in their last two fights. Tenacity, Filipino pride, Japanese pride on the line.
Oh, good right hand, straight right from Ueda.
Kevin looks like he's loading up that right hand. Let's see if he lets it go. Nice, stuffs a shot from Ueda.
Belingon just scooted his legs out the way there so they couldn't be grasped. His takedown defense is getting better and better.
Little short kick, returned by Ueda. And the right hand, southpaw versus orthodox. One, two, down the pipe.
A counter right hand from Ueda. It was a very nice one. Belingon comes back with the kicks. And the kick to the midriff looked to be a little bit low. Sure enough, Yuji Shimada has called time. Up to 5 minutes for the Japanese fighter to gather himself.
Unintentional, but nonetheless, it did ring the bell.
He says he's okay, and they carry on. Didn't take anything like the 5 minutes he could have done. Look at these two. Belingon slightly ahead for me. Jason, how do you see it so far?
I think Ueda's ahead. I think that Ueda with those takedown attempts has been a little bit more aggressive, and I think that he's looked to set up submissions, which could be the determining factor. But you know what? If I was any good at judging fights, I'd be a judge, not a commentator.
Well, he did have a very good second round, didn't he, Ueda?
He did. And you know, regardless of who wins this, Ueda is a spectacular MMA fighter. He's 35 years old, and you've got Kevin Belingon's 25. He's got another 10, 12 years of prime MMA experience to come, and a guy like Ueda has just seen so much combat. Being in there with him is just going to sharpen your sword.
Well, Belingon saw a big right hand come over his guard and cuff him around the left eye, and that was a really sprightly right jab. Very, very fast, like a cobra pouncing on him.
You know, I've been a fan of Ueda ever since I was in Brazil at AFC and saw him fight Horler Gracie, who's one of the best jiu-jitsu guys in the world.
He just sent a stunning right hand over to Belingon, who's really eating a few punches now.
Yep, and like you just said, you know, he threw that punch that was over the top. Nice hands, but he is a great jiu-jitsu guy, great wrestler, and very solid hands. Kevin has great kicks, great tenacity. Can he stuff this takedown? He's out of danger.
It's the second time we've seen that. Ueda goes for the takedown and gets a kick in the head. It's a fascinating contest, I should say. A clash of styles that is really enthralling.
You know, regardless of who wins, I'm buying both of their t-shirts tomorrow. This has been a great fight.
More abuse to Belingon's head from foot and fist. And I think you might be right, Jason. Ueda may be just edging ahead if he hasn't done so already.
Ooh, nice kick and right hand combo. Stuffs a takedown, big knee.
The crowd really
nice
getting
kick.
Behind Belingon.
Kevin looking to finish here.
As he powers his way through the Japanese fighter on the cage wall. Belingon now. With the noise of 20,000 people behind him, Ueda's got blood all over his nose.
Kevin gets into top position, and this is going to be interesting. I don't think we've seen Ueda on his back yet. Kevin looks like he's looking for the choke. Is he going to get the rear naked on Ueda?
Slips out.
Big cut opened up on Ueda from those punches.
And a knee to the head won't make it any better either. Belingon now sees his chance with 2 minutes left in this contest. The crowd are going crazy here.
Kevin doing what Horler Gracie couldn't, mounting to Saku Ueda, now taking the back. Gotta be careful here, he's gotta slide off and Ueda's gonna be in cross-side.
It's one transition after another.
What a spectacular fight. Both guys showing why they're here in the final.
The blood on both bodies is coming from Ueda. And is Belingon swinging his way back into a victorious position? I would not like to be a judge tonight.
This is the first time in 8 or 9 fights of Ueda's I've seen that he's actually been damaged. Big cut over the eye, was reversed. Nice head kick.
70 seconds left.
Fights like this make fans of MMA. Great back and forth action.
Oh, that was a slip, I think, although he did eat a punch and another right hand. And now Ueda could be in trouble. But he comes back with a kick and takes the double leg takedown. Up pops Belingon again. In It's desperate stuff from both men. It could be anyone's fight. And with 40 seconds left, both men know it.
Ueda moves into cross side again. He looks like he could be setting up a choke here. Now he's content just to stay cross side and grind this out with some punches. What a great fight.
Well, absolutely right. I mean, what entertainment this is. The elbow to the head comes in from Ueda. And Belingon now, subject to ground and pound, but switches over, gives his back to the Japanese fighter.
He's got 10 seconds left.
Too little, too late, surely.
And all three judges see it for your winner by unanimous decision. And the winner of the Bantamweight Grand Prix Final from the blue corner, Masakatsu Ueda!
Ueda takes it, and to be perfectly honest, you couldn't argue with that. Kevin Belingon's ONE FC career record drops to 3-2. Ueda's in tears. Victor Kui has presented him with a mammoth Grand Prix trophy.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.